Good day, this is Jim Pytel from Columbia Gorge Community College. This is Digital Electronics 1. This lecture is entitled Universal Properties of NAND and NOR Gates. We have discussed a bunch of basic logic gates. We first discussed the AND, the OR, and the NOT, and then we introduced the NAND and the NOR and their negative logic equivalents, the negative AND and the negative OR, and then we also introduced the XOR, no, it's exclusive OR, the exclusive NOR gate. I showed you how you can make all those other gates with combinations of the AND and the OR and the NOT. However, what if I was to tell you it's not really done that way? You use another basic component to make the ANDs and the ORs and the NOTs. And if that's true, if that one basic component is making those basic gates, what I'm trying to tell you is that one basic component hooked up in different configurations is making any logic circuit that we can possibly create. What it really is, you're actually making is these NAND and NOR gates. What's inside a NAND and a NOR gate? Well, for this course, you don't need to know. For semiconductor devices and circuits, you're going to crack these things open. You're going to make one of these things. It's super simple what's inside them. And that's why you use the NANDs and the NOR gates. They're super simple to make. They're super simple to mass produce. And if you can hook them up in different configurations, you can create a NOT, an AND, an OR. If you can use a NOT, AND, an OR, you can make a NAND. Well, you'll see. It's easier. Obviously, how do you make a NAND out of a NAND? You just use a NAND. You don't have to do anything funky with it. A NOR, negative OR, negative AND, exclusive OR, exclusive NOR. And you can take all these things in crazy combinations and build higher functional combinational logic circuits, and sequential for that matter. This lecture is going to be too easy. It's an incredibly important topic, but it is too easy to understand what I'm going to talk about here, because you guys are experts by now, and you can go ahead and spit out the truth table for a NAND and for a NOR without looking at your cheat sheet. And if it took you longer to write that truth table on your notepad because you're actively listening to this thing than it took me to copy and paste it, you need to go back and look at the NAND and the NOR gate. If you're still looking this thing up right now, you got some work to do. You need to know how these things work. When I say know, you need to be able to, at a moment's notice, spit out the truth table for these things without consulting some resource. That being said, I'm going to leave the NAND gate and the NOR gate truth table here for those individuals that potentially need some assistance. We may be even consulting these things. So the universal properties of the NAND and NOR gates, essential to this is obviously your understanding of the NAND and the NOR gates, how they work initially. But I've already referred to this in the NAND and NOR gate lectures. This guy. How do I make a NOT gate using just a NAND gate? Let's just stick to the NANDs right now. How do I make a NOT gate? All right, this is take a NAND. It's got two inputs. Tie its inputs together and put a digital data signal on it. Up, down, up, down, up, down. What are the two inputs getting? It's getting the same value. So when it's zero, when that waveform A is zero, what are the two inputs getting? Zero and a zero. Look at your truth table. It's getting a zero and a zero. What's my output? A one. Oh my gosh, it's inverted it. When that digital data is getting a 1, what are my two inputs getting? A 1 and a 1. Where on my truth table? If a 1 and a 1 are on the inputs, what's my output? 0. Oh my gosh, it's inversion. So if a NAND gate with its two inputs tied together, it is functionally equivalent to a NOT gate. And if you can understand that, you can build an AND gate. And if you can understand that, you can build an OR gate. Okay, I'm challenging you to go ahead and do that. If this is true, right here, if I can swap out a NOT gate for a NAND gate with its two inputs tied together, how can I create an AND gate out of just NAND gates? And I need you to pause the lecture. I need you to think about this. How do you do it? Okay, if you've paused the lecture, you've probably come up with the following action. Okay, if a NAND gate really is and functionally equivalent to an AND gate with its output inverted, right? So it's A, B. What is this? It's A and B. What's this? Well, it's A and B inverted. You may be using rule 9, which states that A, something inverted, inverted again, is equal to A. Why not put another inverter here? So if this thing is a NAND gate, and I can make an inverter out of another NAND gate, what's that look like? It looks like this. NAND gate, inputs A and B, output into another NAND gate with its inputs tied together. That's your AND gate. It's functionally equivalent to an AND gate. Don't believe me? Put in a truth table. A, B, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. What's the output of the NAND gate? A and B inverted. What is the truth table? Don't even look it up. 1, 1, 1, 0. The only time it's low is when all inputs are high. What is this guy? Well, it's getting 1 and a 1 for this first thing here. When it's getting a 1 and a 1, where are we on this truth table? A 0, a 0, a 0. Now we're getting, over here, both inputs are getting a 0. What's our output? Output is a 1. What's that truth table look like? Well, it's A and B inverted, inverted again. What's double inversion? A and B. What's that truth table look like? It looks like an AND gate. Okay, this is really cool. And what you do is just use this thing. Think of this thing as a box. Here is a box with inputs A and B on the left-hand side. I put X on the right, and I know there's a NAND gate in there feeding another NAND gate with its two inputs tied together. But what's it performing? It's the same thing as what's inside this box. It's got two inputs A and B on the left and an output X on the right. And it's performing that same truth table as an AND gate. Let's take it a little step further here. Okay, we've talked about using a NAND gate as an inverter, and we've talked about using the NAND gate in different combinations to make an AND gate. This is a little bit tricky. How do I make an OR gate out of a NAND gate? So look at our little symbols here, which we've drawn. I want you to find the negative logic equivalent of the NAND gate. Okay, the negative logic equivalent for a NAND gate is this guy right there, the negative OR. See if you can take a negative OR, which is a NAND gate, and see if you can make an OR gate out of that. Okay, hopefully your drawing looks like this. Okay, so there is my negative OR. It's an OR with its inputs inverted. How do I get rid of that inverted input? Inverted again right there. Well, I just told you that I could take a NAND gate and tie its inputs together to make an inverter. What am I creating here? Because the negative OR is equivalent to a NAND, I'm creating the functional equivalent of an OR gate inside a box A, B, X. If I look at this from the box, inputs A and B have an output X that's functional equivalent to an OR gate inside a box. Don't believe me? Go ahead and try it out. So I got A, I got B. What is happening to A and B? I'm inverting them. Not A, not B. Oops. Pen issues. What's happening to not A and not B? So not A, not B. I'm ANDing them together and then inverting the result. I'm basically doing the NAND of this. The output is low when all inputs are high, right there. What's that truth table look like? That looks like an OR gate's truth table. The output is high when any input is high. And I'm saying this is the input right here, because that's what I originally start with. Don't think of this is the input, because we're on this side of the box. Okay? That is how you make AND gates. That's how you make NOT gates, AND gates, and OR gates out of just the NAND. Okay, and there, that's something you might want to put on your cheat sheet, but man, it is so easy. It's so easy. You don't even need to put that on your cheat sheet, because you already know what I'm talking about. A NAND with its inputs tied together, that's a NOT. A NAND feeding a NAND-based inverter, that's an AND. A NAND with its inputs inverted with a NAND-based inverter, that's the functional equivalent to a OR gate. So I just showed you how to do that with NAND gates. Now I'm challenging you, figure out how you do that with NOR gates. And I'm going to throw a bone to you. What is a NOR gate with its inputs tied together? If you can understand this, it should be too easy to create a NOT gate. It should be too easy to create an OR gate. It should be too easy to create an AND gate. Okay, if you've done what I'm asking you to do, what is a NOR gate with its two inputs tied together? Let me clean up, because I was talking about NANDs earlier. Okay, there you go. If I've got a digital data signal coming in, up, down, up, down, up, down, it's taking the value 0. What are the two inputs getting? It's getting a 0 and a 0. What's my output? 1. Okay, I've inverted it. Now it's a 1. Both inputs are getting a 1. My output is 0. I've inverted. A NOR with its inputs tied together. Functionally equivalent to an inverter. How do I make an OR out of a NOR? Well, if a NOR is an inverted OR, you're basically ORing something, then inverting it. Why not re-invert the output using a, yeah, you guessed it, a NOR with its inputs tied together. Functionally equivalent to an OR gate. If a NOR is equivalent to a negative AND, it's negative logic equivalent, how do I make an AND out of just NOR gates? Well, I'll take the negative logic equivalent, a negative AND, and invert the inputs. But I want to use just NORs. Take a NOR, tie its inputs together. Take a NOR, tie its inputs together. And since I want to use the same symbol, it's going to look like this. And there's the whole cheat sheet. You've got your NOR with its inputs tied together. It's functionally equivalent to a NOT. You've got a NOR with its output being inverted with a NOR-based inverter. It's equivalent to an OR. And then we've got an AND gate, which is a NOR with its inputs inverted using NOR-based inverters. So this is really neat. You've got many different logic functions all formed from the same gate. This is everybody in your squad is shooting 5.56 ammunition. No one's got some crazy weird caliber musket ball that you can't use in your rifle. It's the same piece of equipment used over and over in different combinations so you can perform crazy different logic functions. Hopefully this is easy for you. This is, should have been pretty easy discussion. No use beating a dead horse. Just let's see if we can apply this thing. Just take a logic circuit and see if you can make that same logic circuit using just NANDs or just NORs. Here's an example right here. Okay, here's put our cheat sheet off to the left-hand side. I don't know if you need it, but let's go ahead and see if you can, for the output X right there for that particular logic circuit, for our three-input logic circuit, go ahead and see if you can create a NAND equivalent. What I'm going to do this is draw a box around the OR, draw a box around the AND. Take out the contents of the box and put in the NAND equivalent of what was in the box. It should look like this. Make sure to make our life ever so slightly more easy. Make that a red box. There you go. Too easy. You could do the exact same thing. Try to implement that circuit using just NOR gates. You should look something like this. And there you go. That is the NOR equivalent of the original circuit we started with. And that's what I would call correct-ish. It's correct-ish. Yes, it's performing the output X like we'd expect. And I dare you guys to do the truth tables for the original one, for the NAND-based logic, and then for the NOR. It's going to come up with the same truth table. And the expression, use Demorgans. These are great, great opportunities to do some Demorgans theorems and Boolean logic simplification. However, there exists something in this bottom circuit, the NOR-based circuit, that I could potentially simplify. And when I say make this circuit using just NOR gates, I need to actually kind of insert a kind of a qualifier to that. Use the minimum number of NOR gates. Is there something in our lower circuit that we could potentially save some connections? And what I'm referring to is right here. What is this guy doing? Well, it's a NOR gate with its inputs tied together. What's that? It's a NOT gate. What's this guy? That's a NOR gate with its inputs tied together. What is it doing? It's acting like an inverter. Why an hex name am I taking a signal, inverting it, uninverting it? Okay, what am I using there? I'm using rule 9, the double inversion. Sounds like I can save some connections. Forget those two NOR gates. What does my simplified circuit look like? It looks like this. There you go. Problem with that, though, is I can't really define them in the red boxes and the blue boxes like I did before. If I had purple, one of my least favorite colors, what I would have to kind of do is, let's just do an overlap right there. If I required that intermediary signal, I've kind of lost it in this implementation. Go ahead and see if you can come up with it. Like I said, these are great opportunities for multi-level circuit analysis and Demorgans theorem. Try to do the Demorgans theorem equivalent of this with some Boolean simplification. Same thing for that. You should come up with the same results in this one too. Try one more example of this and then just put this topic to bed. I mean, this is too easy. Just take the box, take the contents out of the box, put in the box the equivalent. Let's try one more. Okay, so here's another example. It's like a 4-input circuit this time. And I'm going to give you a challenge on this one. You should instantly go for it. Yeah, that's easy. But I'm going to give you a challenge this time. You can only use 2-input NAND gates. Okay, so try it to implement the circuit using just two input NAND gates. Once you're done with that, try to implement the circuit with just two input NOR gates. Okay, so hopefully you've come up with something like this. Well, first off, how do I make this circuit? I've got a three input AND gate. Don't worry about the NAND conversion right now. How do I make a three input AND gate out of just two input AND gates? It should look something like this. Okay, so what is coming out of here? A ANDed with not B. What's coming out of here? C or D. What is this last AND gate doing? It's ANDing A and B with C or D. That's the same expression that's happening here. It's taking A ANDing with B, excuse me, not B, ANDing it with the results of C or D. Same expression. And what I've done is I've created a three input AND gate out of these two nested AND gates using the associative property of AND gates. Okay, so that might help out a little bit. Go ahead, see if you can come up with the NAND equivalent. Hopefully you should look something like this. And there you go. There's the NAND equivalent. Is there opportunities for some... Actually, let me just draw this here real quick for you. Where is the inverter for B? It's that one. Where is this AND gate? It's that one. Where is this OR gate? It's this one. I'm basically just taking the contents of the box and just putting in the NAND equivalent of it. Is there opportunities for simplification? No. Can I redraw this thing? Perhaps in a different fashion, maybe. You know, maybe I could use like the negative logic equivalent, the negative OR. It's not really going to help us. I know it seems more complicated, but if the NAND is an incredibly simple, cheap part to make, it's pretty neat that you can go ahead and take and think of it in terms of a PLD, programmable logic devices. Here's just a sea, an endless sea of unhooked up NAND gates stretching out to infinity. And if I could somehow program these unconnected NANDs to perform NOT gates and perform AND gates to perform OR gates, and then take those NAND-based NOTs, ANDs, and ORs to create NANDs. No, well, obviously you're not going to create a NAND out of it because it's a NAND. NORs, exclusive ORs, exclusive NORs, and then build up to make adders. And it's pretty cool. You know, it's a neat way of doing things. Okay, here's another challenge. Take the same circuit, make a NOR-based equivalent of it. Okay, there is my initial attempt at a NOR-based equivalent of that. Where is the inverter for B? Right there. Where's that first AND gate? Whoops, got to change the color. Right there. Where is the OR? That one. And where is my final AND gate? Right there. Where in here might I be able to simplify? I reduce the number of connections that I need. And long story short, it's always those double negations. When you start looking at these things, start looking for times where there's an inverter, a NOR-based inverter, or a NAND-based inverter, because you could do this for NANDs, where they are two inverters feeding each other. Why would you ever do something like that? Okay, think about right here and right there. I can remove them entirely. I don't even need those things. Okay, let's go ahead and redraw that again. So there is the same circuit using the minimum number of NOR gates. What have I lost? I've lost access to that C or D signal. And additionally, I've lost access to that not B signal. Potentially, you know, I don't know, you need not B and C or D for some other logical output. You know, here's X, here's Y. You may need those things. What have you gained here? Well, if you don't need those things, don't worry about it. What have you gained? Less power consumption. If you really are implementing these things out of fixed function integrated circuits, less gates. That's it, guys. I mean, this is really, really simple. You should know the truth table of the NAND, the negative logic equivalent, the negative OR, and the NOR and its negative logic equivalent, the negative AND, for you to understand this. And you should be able to use, again, Boolean rules to go ahead and simplify this. If you've got those double inverters feeding each other, why would you ever do something like that? Okay, let's bring this lecture to a close and move on to the next subject.